What's going on, guys? Welcome back. Another tutorial today in Photoshop on how I edit my photos. So today I did something a bit different. So I've already posted the photo on Instagram, but I'm going to show you how to make your head bigger in Photoshop, just because why not? Literally, this is what I'm coming down to now during this lockdown, during this quarantine. Got nothing else to do other than mess around and make myself look funny. So yeah, we're going to jump into Photoshop straight away. And first of all, you can see this image of me here, wearing only the blind, of course, cheeky little plug. So yeah, as you can see, looking dashing as always. So the first thing to do is we are going to basically cut out the head. It's going to be a really quick tutorial of this. So we're going to cut out the head quite loosely. The head's on a white background, so it's really not much of an issue. It makes life so much easier. This is why I chose the location, this kind of shot, because otherwise I did it outside or in front of like some bushes or just a cluttered space, it'd be a lot harder. So a cleaner background does help you out massively when doing this, if you want to try it yourself. Really simple, just a few steps. So the first thing I'm going to do, we're just going to cut our head out here. As you can see, very loose. Just going to go below the shadow as well, just so we can have that room to play around with later when it comes to actually editing it. Then the next thing to do is Command J. We're just going to make it into a new layer. So you can see now this is a completely new layer. Then the next thing to do is Command T, and that is going to make your selection into a transform tool. So therefore we can just quickly just make the head bigger, maybe rotate it a bit more. You could go as literally as big as you want with it. What the hell? Oh my, imagine. Oh my god. Anyway, well, stop being stupid. All right, we're gonna make this just a bit bigger. Let's go a bit bigger again. There we go, that'll do. That's just a bit abnormal, so that's perfect. Maybe just back a bit. So the next thing to do is create a mask, because we're going to start erasing this. Obviously you can see the edges here where the whites don't match up a bit, but like I said, it's really easy to do. Then you're going to go into your brush tool, make sure it's set as black. Then you're going to start erasing this away, and I'm going to change the flow down to 50%, so it's like a nice gradual change. And I'm going to change the brush into a soft brush as well. And now you can see now the hard edges have been removed. So you can do this as neatly or as roughly as you want. As you can see, I'm doing it quite rough here because the background's all very similar, so there's not much difference being made. The last thing to do is then to realign the head with the body, so it all just looks like it's still connected. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna come around to almost the jawline of my head, where the shadow is. I'm gonna start erasing that, and you can start to see it starting to blend in the center there. Then I'm gonna come back up again, remove my neck. There we go. Make sure it's nice and nice hard line again, so just keep erasing. Then I'm just gonna soften this bit up here again. Maybe just harden this edge up. Let's go back a bit. You can see a bit of my head. Let's just rearrange the head here. Drop it a bit lower. Now, that's pretty much it. As simple as that. So all you gotta do is cut around your head, Command J, put it onto a separate layer, then literally rearrange the head, scale it as big as you want. Then it's pretty much done. All you gotta do is erase the rough edges, and that's it. Then there's your head just looking goofy as hell. It's a nice little trick, you know, just trying to do like nice fun creative things to show you guys and how just to manipulate photography a different bit. I've got another one coming this week, which is going to be really cool as well. I'm just going to shoot that. I've got the stock image, but yeah, it's just look out for it on my page. But another cool photography tutorial. So anyway, yeah, I hope you liked it. Nice and easy. You know, no messing around here, simple tips. Anyway, glad you like it. And let me know down in the comments if you're gonna copy it or not and try and use it, because it's a fun, simple idea to do. Anyway, thanks for watching, subscribe. Peace.